supposed to be doing this live on Facebook today, but I don't have the proper equipment to be able to go live on YouTube yet. So I was thinking it'd be kind of similar to Facebook, but apparently it's not. I tried doing a practice run last night and found out that a little bit more involved in it. So welcome back to Hunting NC Outdoors. This is just a little bit different. Not out in the woods today, not out in the stand hunting or anything, but Christmas time is coming, and I just wanted to play a few Christmas carols for everybody. It's been a tough year for everybody. It's been a little different, you know, with everything going on, and so I figured this might be a way I might be able to just, you know, I like the old Christmas songs. A lot of the new Christmas songs they're coming out with today just doesn't seem like Christmas to me. But I like the old Christmas carols, and it wasn't long ago my dad gave me this Christmas carol book. I've been probably ever since, I'd say probably July and August, I've been working on Christmas music. And he had some old Christmas carols that he gave me, and this is a old Christmas carol book. It's got the piano arrangements. I cannot play by note. Everything I do is strictly by ear. I couldn't tell you one thing about playing by note. So I try and do my best just doing it all by ear. And so today, I'm not going to be able to play all of them in this book, but it's one of the old Christmas carol books. And I don't know if you can see that very well or not. And then each song in here, some of you guys might remember these from when you were kids. My dad used to use these when he was a kid. And every song has its own little picture in it. That one right there is Away in a Manger, which is what we will be starting with. That just kind of gives you an idea. And it shows what key that the song is written in. And so some of them I'm going to play in the proper key. Some of them might be in just a different key. So bear with me on that. And like I said, I am no professional at all. And so it's about a 110% guarantee that I'm going to make some mistakes today, especially with Christmas music. And if anybody is watching this video that knows how to do music, you know what I'm talking about when it comes to Christmas songs. There are some of them Christmas songs are some of the hardest ones to play. And but we're going to try it today for you guys. I hope you enjoy it. We're just going to do an old Christmas traditional style, nothing fancy, nothing big rhythms or anything. Everything's just going to be all traditional style. And we're going to do our best for you today. Again, welcome back to Hunting NC Outdoors. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. And this will probably go up on Facebook. And thank you. I want to thank all my Facebook friends for watching this as well. And so we're going to get started today, and hope you enjoy it. Thank you. also in this book, there's some in here I remember hearing as a kid, growing up, but I can, for the life of me, I cannot remember the tune. It has the O Thou Joyful Day. I remember that I heard the bells on Christmas Day, but I've not been able to master that one yet. There's two different ways to play that one. Here's one I believe everybody's going to recognize. Joy to the World, just do it traditional style. Let's see. It shows it's written in the key of D, but we're going to put it in the key of C. Kids. All right, let's try it. All right. Pull this up, the old song called Silent Night. And if you have not heard the story behind Silent Night, you need to go online and check it out. I'll tell you what, it's got a good story behind how the song was written. And I just love this old Christmas carol. And let's see if we can do it for you. Thank you. Okay, here's another one for the kids. I know they will like this one. I know my kids will enjoy it, and I hope that you guys will too. I just enjoy music. Let's see. Actually, I'm very nervous about being on camera. So, oh, come all you faithful, I'm gonna give it a shot. Thank you.
Hark the Herald Angels Sing. I believe this is the one they sing on Charlie Brown Christmas. That's one of my favorite Christmas shows.
Thank you.
came upon a midnight clear. You go ahead and stop. We're going to pause this thing, and we'll be right back with you guys. We're running out of time on the card, and we'll finish this out in just a second. See you in just a minute. Welcome back again. Sorry about that. The card was getting ready to run out, so we had to take and download it on the computer and then come back and see if we could finish this out. So y'all bear with us. The big memory card we got for the camera, for some reason, is not working on the computer anymore. Or even in the camera, for some reason it's not reading, so I'm not sure what's going on there. So we had to get some new cards, and we ended up getting a little bit smaller cards, and so we can't hold as much memory on there. But we're going to get back at this, and I appreciate you guys being here with us. It probably didn't even seem like a second to y'all, but it took probably about 10 minutes for us to get all that done, so you bear with us. What child is this? I'm glad to know that this Christmas season, you know, every Christmas season that we've celebrated in the past, up to this one and even in the future, the whole meaning of Christmas is all about Jesus and the birth, and he done all of that. He came down to be born in that manger for me and you, for the whole world, so that one day he could die and give his only son. So he could die and give his life for us. God gave his only son to be born in that manger, to be hung on the cross, to be put in the tomb. And then 3 days later, he defeated death, hell, and the grave, and he arose, and he went back to heaven. And that's what we celebrate this Christmas season, is the birth of Jesus, the Savior, the one who defeated death and hell, the one who defeated the grave, and the one who is in heaven now. And, you know, the way things are looking, that, you know, if you read your Bible and you go into the book of Revelation and through different parts of the Bible, you can just see this world. The Bible tells us that things are going to continue to get worse and continue to get worse. And, you know, we just can't help but realize that, hey, you know, it's getting close. Nobody knows the day, nor the hour, nor the second, the minute. Nobody knows the time that Jesus is coming back. But we have that promise in the Bible that he is coming back for us. And what a great time that is going to be when we get to go to heaven. So let's see if we can play this for you. What child is this? Started playing it not too long ago. This is a good old Christmas song. I like it. It's actually the words to it. The title is "I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas." And
You know, I don't know, it seems like every time I think of that song or I hear it, you know, it just kind of brings me back. I remember up to about the ages 5 or 6, we lived up in the state of Indiana, and we lived out in the country, and it was nothing every year, you know, from the time I was born up to age 5 or 6, to see snow on the ground every Christmas. And, you know, the snow we got up there growing up, you know, it was nothing to get, you know, a couple feet of snow. And, you know, every time I hear this song, I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. It just kind of brings me back, you know, since we've been here in the South, you know, here in North Carolina. We lived in Tennessee for a while. Since we've come this way, the snow's just not quite like it was up north. So we don't see it, you know, like we did growing up. I remember going out with the old runner sleds, you know, snow tubing up and down the hill. You know, it was just, you know, it was fun making, you know, tunnels in the snow and, you know, sledding through them. It was fun. Every time I hear "I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas," it just kind of brings me back and kind of reminds me, you know, growing up, what the white Christmases and stuff we used to have. But somebody also put some Christian words to it. "I'm Dreaming of a Real Christmas." It's pretty good. But I really like this song, and I hope you enjoy it. Like it was a tradition that whether you was Christmas caroling or even at church growing up, it just seemed like around Christmas time it'd either be the end of the congregational or
it'd be at the very end of the message. We would always end with, "We wish you a Merry Christmas." And so we want to end the video today with that, and see how it goes here. Appreciate everybody joining in with us. Again, this is Hunting NC Outdoors. A little bit different. We're not in the stand. Although I did go this morning. Didn't have any luck. Did have one come in on me, but she kind of snuck in. She was a big old doe. But didn't get anything today. Had my mind and focus on this. Appreciate you all being here. Again, this has just been a crazy year. Usually we like to try and go out and do a little caroling or something like that, but right now they kind of encouraging everybody not to go to too many doors, so we don't want to do anything to offend anyone or anything like that, just trying to do our best. But this is just another way I tried to reach out to everybody, and from my family here, my wife Jessica and the kids, we want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas and just remember this Christmas season. It's not all about the gifts under the tree. It's not about, you know, all that, what kind of money you spend or what kind of food you're going to have on the table. All that stuff is nice. Let's not forget, you know, the real meaning of Christmas. And that would be the first part of Christmas, which is Christ, C-H-R-I-S-T. Let's not forget him. You know, he's the reason for Christmas. He's the reason we celebrate it. You know, we have fun with Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. The kids like watching it. Frosty the Snowman. And we play around with Santa Claus and stuff like that. But we've raised our kids just as I was raised to know the real meaning of Christmas. And that's all about the birth of Jesus Christ and the reason he came and was born in that manger. And would you go get my Bible for me? Before we close this video, I just want to share a few verses of scripture with you. Just to encourage you, you know, a lot of people get stressed around the holidays and different things. This ain't a time to be stressed out. This ain't a time to be worried about how much we can spend or what we're going to do. Just to remember that Jesus was born in that manger. God gave his only son. I know I can quote it, but I want to make sure that I get it word for word. I don't want to miss anything. A very familiar passage of scripture, especially around this time of year. I want to take a look over here in the book of Luke real quick, and then we'll be done. Luke chapter 2, the Bible says, "And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria, and all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you,
ye shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it goes on there, but we see there that the whole meaning of Christmas is about Jesus Christ's birth. God gave his only son through the Virgin Mary to come down and be born in an old, nasty manger for me and you. You know, a lot of times we think it would be nice to be able to live back in the Bible days because, you know, a lot of times you think about in the Bible days when Jesus walked the earth, everything was perfect. No, everything was not perfect. There was a time when Jesus first created the heavens and the earth. When he first created everything down here, it was perfect. But then man, after he created man and man sinned in the garden, that's where everything went from being perfect to sinful, to being wicked. That's where it all started. And we read here where the Bible says there wasn't even any room for him in the inn. They wouldn't even let the Mary go into the inn there, or what we would consider a motel room today. Wouldn't even let her be in to give birth to the Savior of the world. They didn't have room for him. Everything was sold out. And the only thing they had was a stable where the animals lay in sleep. And that didn't stop Jesus Christ from taking off his robe of righteousness and coming down and being born in the old manger where the animals sleep and use the bathroom and eat. That didn't stop him one bit. It didn't stop God one bit from giving his only son to be born in that old dirty rotten stable. Instead, that was the plan. And that plan was fulfilled. And after he was born, you know, 33 and a half years later, that same that baby that was born in that manger, a 33 and a half year old man, then gave his only life. He didn't stop there in the manger. He went all the way to being crucified, to being beaten, to being torn, to being spat upon, and everything that he went through, it didn't stop him. And he laid his life down on that cross, and he died on that cross for me and for you. And then, like I said earlier, 3 days later, he defeated death, hell, and the grave. And that's the man we celebrate this year for Christmas. And, you know, like I said, it's not about the money you spend. It's not about what you get under the tree. It's not how big of a meal you have on the table. It's all about that man. His name is Jesus, who was born in that manger for me and you. So one day he could die on that cross. And I appreciate you being a part of this video today. I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry I messed up a little bit. I'm nervous being on camera, but when it comes to stuff like this, I can go out in the woods and stuff with you all day long and not think once about it. But for some reason, sitting here playing these keys right here just makes me a little nervous. But hey, I want to wish you guys a Merry Christmas here from Hunting NC Outdoors. Sorry about that. We want to wish you guys a very Merry Christmas. And we're hoping and praying that 2021 will be a better year than what 2020 was. But you know, I serve the one who holds tomorrow. I don't have to worry about it. And he's got everything under control. And I'm thankful for that. And hope you all have a Merry Christmas and a wonderful new year. And hey, hopefully here in the next few days, we might be able to get back out in the woods and see what we can do out there in the woods again. And like I said, this is going to be going on YouTube. So all my friends here on YouTube, thank you all so much for watching. And if any of my friends on YouTube or on Facebook, thank all my friends on Facebook. And if any of my friends on Facebook hadn't subscribed yet, please go to YouTube and subscribe to my channel, Hunting NC Outdoors. And you can see what we have going on there. Here in at the very first of January, I've got a great video I can't wait to be able to put on here to show you guys. It's going to be great. I can't wait to get that up. So please be watching, be aware. If you hadn't already, please subscribe to the channel and share it. And then all my friends here on YouTube, if you want, you can go on Facebook. You can find me on there under Andrew Dice. Put my profile there. And I'd like for you to be friends with me there. But anyways, you guys have a Merry Christmas. We will see you on the next one. And God bless each and every one of you. You guys have a wonderful day.